I'm going to get him to talk to him right here. You know, as long as I've been dealt here, we had nothing but a couple of drunks and vagrants and a couple of chickadees. Our best cat is that fellow from Minnesota who chopped up his wife. We had to extradite him. Seems kind of queer having a school teacher here. Thunderproof right on the wall, so.
Everybody, look here!
Oh.
I at the mansion.
Well, I suppose that's okay for them that practically likes having a privy in the bedroom.
The unplumbed and plumbingless dents. Ah, Hillsboro. Heavenly Hillsboro, the buckle on the Bible belt.
Hot dog?
Bye, bye. Now this poses a pretty problem. Which is hungrier, I wonder, my stomach or my soul? My stomach. Thank you.
What are you? An evolutionist? An infidel?
A sinner? Oh, the worst kind. I write for a newspaper. T.J. Hornback, Baltimore Herald. I don't believe I caught your name.
They call me Elijah.
Elijah? Yes. Why, I think I've read some of your stuff. I didn't know you were still around.
I neither read nor write.
Oh, I must have been thinking of another Elijah.
Grandpa!
Well, welcome to Hillsboro, sir. Have you come to testify for the defense or for the prosecution? No comment?
That's fairly wise.
But I warn you, sir, you can't compete with all these monkey shines.
The train's coming. I seen the smoke way up the track.
All the members of the Bible League, get ready. Let us show Mr. Brady the spirit with which we welcome him to Hillsboro. Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
We're marching.
Oh, perhaps we should have a more
you a commission as honorary colonel in our state militia.
Colonel Brady, I like that.
We thought you might be hungry, Colonel Brady, after your long train ride.
Mr. Brady, Colonel Brady, all of us here voted for you three times.
I trust it was in three separate elections.
Yes, sir.
Sir, I'm Tom Davenport.
Yes, District Circuit Attorney. We're going to be quite a team, young man, quite a team. Look at this handsome repast they've laid out for us. How good it will be to strap on the old armor again, to go up against the blasphemies of science.
Now, Matt, it's a warm day. Remember what the doctor told you about overeating?
Oh, just a bite, Mother. Now then, who among you knows the defendant? I think Cage is his name?
Oh, well, we all know him, sir.
Just about everybody in Hillsboro knows everybody else.
This Cage, is he a criminal by nature?
Good isn't a criminal. He's good, really.
Oh, my dear. Is Mr. Cage a friend of yours?
Can't tell you anything about him.
Rachel, my daughter will be pleased to answer any of your questions about Mr. Burton Cage.
Your daughter, Reverend? Why, you must be proud. Proud indeed. How did you come to be acquainted with Mr. Cage?
School. I'm a school teacher, too.
I'm sure you teach according to the precepts of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. I try to. My pupils are on the second grade.
Has Mr. Cage ever tried to pollute your mind with his heathen dogma?
Bert isn't a heathen.
Well, I understand your reluctance to talk about him. This man in your jail, I'm sure he's a likable fellow, but you don't want to speak out in front of all these people. Rachel, consider me a friend. Tell me what's troubling you.
Well, I wonder who the attorney for the defense is going to be.
Oh, well, we don't know yet, Mr. Bannister. It hasn't been announced.
Well, whoever he is, he won't stand much of a chance against your husband.
I disagree.
And who are you?
Hornbeck, E.K. Hornbeck, Baltimore Herald.
Hornbeck? Hornbeck.
I am a newspaper man, bearing news. When this sovereign state determined to indict the sovereign mind of a less-than-sovereign schoolteacher, my editors decided there was more than just a story here. The Baltimore Herald, therefore, is happy to announce it is sending two representatives to heavenly Hillsboro. The most brilliant journalist in America today, myself, and the most agile legal mind of the 20th century, Henry Drummond.
Drummond?
Henry Drummond, the agnostic?
I heard about him. Why, he's the one who got them two child murders from Chicago off just the other day.
Vile and godless man.
Merry Christmas and happy 4th of July.
Henry Drummond for the defense.
Henry Drummond is the agent of darkness. We will not allow him in this town.
Well, I don't know about what law we can keep him out, right?
I can look it up in our town orders.
I saw Drummond once. I caught him in a hide. The man was on trial for most heinous crimes. Although Drummond knew and even admitted that the man was guilty, he perverted the evidence and turned it away from the accused and onto you and me and all of society.
Oh,
I can still see him. Slimy weasel of a man. Lost his head jutted out like some sort of animal. You look in his face and you wonder, why did God make such a man? Then you realize, God didn't make Henry Drummond. He's a creature of the devil, perhaps even the devil himself.
Oh, Matthew, what they're bringing Henry Drummond for the defense.
Drummond, Henry Drummond.
We will not allow him in this town.
More help.
I believe we should welcome Mr. Drummond.
Welcome him.
Yes. Enemy sends Goliath into battle, it only magnifies our cause. Henry Drummond has stalked these courtrooms for 40 years. Where he goes, headlines follow. The whole world will be witness to our victory over Drummond. The St. George has slain a dragonfly. Who would remember him?
been taught to do the righteous thing.
I'm sure she has. Thank you. And folks, to tomorrow, to the beginning of the trial, and to our victory over Drummond, a toast in good American lemonade!
Ordinary people played a dirty trick on Colonel Brady. They ceased to exist.